Normally, if you press both the F1 and F5 function keys at the same time for 3 seconds, you'll get the setup screen. We can simulate that here by right-clicking and say go to Setup Menu. And there's our setup menu. You have to be in this menu in order to program the panel using the serial cables. If, for some reason, you can't access that setup screen, I can force that by pressing this button. Now pressing F1 and F5 and holding them down for 3 seconds, I'll simulate that here, no longer gets us to the setup menu. No matter how hard I try, I can't get into the setup menu. So the issue here is that the project that's currently loaded into the Seymour has turned off the setup screen. Now this project is set up to do with a push button, but what if a project inadvertently disabled the setup screen? How are you going to get back into the setup screen so you can program the Seymour Micro? There's a whole video on how to prevent access to the setup screen that you may want to watch for tips and tricks on how to take advantage of that. But in a nutshell, there's an internal tag in the Seymour Micro that the project can set to disable the setup screen, which is exactly what this push button is doing. This push button is modifying this internal tag, the sysdisable use of the F1 F5 setup. When that value's on, I cannot access the setup menu. When that value's off, then I can access the setup menu. The problem is, of course, if that tag's enabled and the program doesn't give you a way to disable it, then you can't load a new program via the serial port because programming requires that the panel be put in setup screen mode. This doesn't apply to USB programming. USB programming automatically puts the panel in setup mode. So, if the panel doesn't provide a means to disable that special tag, then your only way back is to reset the panel to factory default. Fortunately, that's easy. Just hold down F2 and F4 at the same time while applying power. The panel may ask you to calibrate the screen, and then you'll find yourself at the setup screen and can now load a new program into the panel. A word of caution, you will lose all contents of the panel when you go back to factory default, so make sure that's what you really want to do. Well, that's all there is to regaining access to that setup screen. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.